Everybody, we're back, and now it's actually story time. So hopefully you're all settled, and you're ready to listen to our wonderful book, Little Ones, by Anne and Paul Rand. I really like this book. I love all the color and the line drawings, and we'll talk a little bit more about that when it's time for our process art project.
Yeah, they don't make this book anymore.
Yeah, we don't think they make this book anymore. It's an old book. For little ones everywhere. Mm-hmm. Little Ones by Anne and Paul Rand. Little One looked like a stick. From the front he was medium thick, but from the side he was so thin he could have been a line. Little One had very small feet and a little red hat that sat on the top of his head. He could hop and skip and spin. He never had much fun because he was only one. I'd like to be two like you, little one said, smiling at two yellow pears that lay in a dish. Go away, said the pears. Two is company, but two plus one is three, and that would be a crowd. The little one sadly set off and right away met three stuffed bears blazing in the sun. If three is a crowd, thought little one, three plus one is four, and that is even more. So he didn't bother to ask if he'd be allowed to bask beside them. But when he began to feel lonely again, little one asked four bees who were building a hive if he might give them a hand. Five can do more than four, he said, but the biggest bee buzzed so angrily that little one scurried. Of five umbrellas standing in a rack, not one answered back when little one cried, may I climb inside? But when he said, I'm sure there's room for six, a pink parasol sniffed. We've no room at all for ordinary six. Where are you going, Charlotte? Charlotte, come back! Thank you. Oh, bringing candy to your sister. I forgot to share with you all that we don't do a lot of candy in our house, and we still have Halloween candy sitting in our garage. Charlotte, scoot over. So, they're eating a little bit of Halloween candy today. So.
And she even gave us a second one.
Yeah, today was a little special. But if Charlotte, can you see where you are? Okay. Little One found six ants searching for crumbs of bread. They were too busy to pay any attention when Little One happened to mention that instead of six, they could as well be seven. Seven mice playing hide and seek with a cat just brushed Little One aside when he said, wouldn't it be fun to make eight out of seven plus one? Eight stiff-backed books on a shelf gave eight cross looks when Little One said, if I stand in line, we could be nine. Charlotte, I can't see the book. Little One was in such despair he hardly dared to stare into a big glass bowl until nine frisky fish. It was gayer when ten could swish. He felt no surprise that each fish blew a bubble, and not one took the trouble even to. Yeah.
That's sad.
Little One felt so alone, he sadly started home. Whatever can be the matter with me, he sighed. Two turned away, and none of the others wanted to play. Don't they know it's no fun to be only one?
Yeah.
Little One was ready to cry when a bright red hoop came looping by. Hi, cried the hoop with a smile. Come and play for a while. But I am only one, said Little One. Oh, no, that's not so, cried the hoop. Don't you know when a circle is empty inside, it looks like zero. Just stand here by me, and then we can pretend to be number 10. Little One and the loop and the hoop, play together in all kinds of places and weather. When Little One pushes, the red hoop swishes away. Little One runs after, shouting with laughter. What did you guys think? You had a good question, loved it. Okay. Well, we are all done with our book, Little One, and I hope you'll come back and check out our craft project that is inspired by all the beautiful colors and lines in this book.
Bye.
See you next time.